Don't ask me! Ask them! Since when was Eugen Hamel one to hide when there was a fight to be had?
Since they stripped me of my rank and banished me from the battlefield. Now I'm stuck driving the backsides of this lot while the city burns and my wife tails off with a man half my age! And then you turn up! What the hell are you doing here anyway?
What indeed?
The enemy numbers 200,000 or more counting the orcs. There are simply not enough soldiers housing in the capital to repel an army of that size.
Then one of the central keep.
Held by a contingent of soldiers and bearers from the surrounding boroughs. They are the sole reason it still stands. And all it took was an army on their doorstep to bring them together.
The prospect of death does put things into perspective.
Perspective. Perhaps it's what we've lacked all along.
Mayhap they are the wrong men.
Well, I'll be damned.
Our numbers are few, but I shall rally as many of my dragoons as I'm able. You, apprise the Lord Strategist of the state of the city's defenses.
Yes, Your Radiance.
And you would fight alongside us?
I owe the Phoenix a debt.
Does this vouch for my nephews?
Aye, but I still have my doubts about you.
Which we can discuss later.
Indeed.
You said you had men garrisoned in the keep. Captain, do you know how many yet remain?
Allow me to confirm. Commander?
Whatever their number, Randalar will be needing them all.
Gather the bodies and build a pyre in the courtyard. Quickly.
Terence.
My lord.
You will find a girl there.
A girl? We are in the middle of a war.
I owe her my life, and I always pay my debts. You are to see that she is provided for.
Dion, I cannot leave.
But you shall. If I am ever to be worthy of the forgiveness of our people, then I must earn it. And I must earn it by my hand, and my hand alone. Know that I do not ask this lightly.
And know that I will do it.
Farewell, Terence.
Prince.
Clive, thank fuck. You all right?
I am. But I'm a damn sight better for seeing you, Joshua.
And Barnabas.
The king is dead.
So they're all...
They are, but so is their killer. He can't hurt anyone anymore. You're safe.
I'm sorry, Clive. You know I want nothing more than to go with you.
I do. But I'm glad you're heading back to the Enterprise nonetheless.
And not just for Edda's sake. Our people need to know what happened here.
You can count on me.
As can she, I hope.
Thank you, my lord.
Do you think that was wise?
Wiser than leaving a woman with child alone in the Deadlands. They'll be safer at the hideaway. For now, at least. This land is overrun with Akashic. The king himself was long turned, albeit by choice. All to serve Ultima, in his damnable quest to forge the perfect vessel.
The chaos Barnabas wreaked, upon nation after nation. How many were killed for this?
He didn't consider it killing. Or a mercy of sorts. A way to end their suffering. He truly wanted to save mankind, and ultimately use that.
As he uses us.
But why us? What are we?
What are we? We are dominance. That is our fate. But that doesn't mean we have to accept it, which is why we fight. For the right to deny it. Is that not so?
It is. For our sins. Barnabas said something else. That the mother crystals were Ultimas.
Ultimas? Are you certain?
We know that the mother crystals have been leading the land of Aether. And we also know that it's this which hastens the spread of the Blight. But what I cannot fathom is what Ultima stands to gain from that. What did you find at the Stronghold?
The truth about Ultima's prize. For so long, I believed it to be you, and you alone. Yet, it is not merely Ifrit that he desires, but Ifrit and Phoenix both, that which we became in the skies over Twinside. Only when the twin flames are joined, shall his vessel be complete. Quite why he needs a vessel is another question. Unless there is something he cannot achieve without one. Something his immaterial form precludes. Something requiring an unthinkable amount of ether and a body resilient enough to channel it. If I did not know better, brother, I would think that he meant to cast a spell. A spell 1,000 years in the making. A spell to end all spells.
But he cannot do it without us. Nor without the Mother Crystals. But if we destroy them all, we will stop not only the Blight, but Ultima as well. We stick to the plan then. Only this time,
we face him together.
Well, it's a long walk to stone here. Let's not keep Ultima waiting.
When Barnabas fell, his magic died with him. The road to stone here is barred to us no longer.
You were right, Joshua. But he's up ahead.
Is there no peace for a dying man?
What happened here?
The ether floods made savage beasts of my companions. And those faithless orcs, I knew they weren't to be trusted. We were told that they would stay loyal to our cause. Something commanded their loyalty, but it was not us.
It's a wonder they stayed faithful for so long.
Perhaps they sensed our downfall. The king is gone, our nation in ruins. What becomes of us loyal pawns now, sworn to a shattered throne? Fuck Walud. Fuck the dead king and his god. Fuck this withered shithole. The floods do not affect you. You are a bearer, albeit one who's lost his brand. Pray, hear me, brother. Will you grant this pawn his final wish? Will you lay my dying soul to rest?
Of course. What do you need?
Finally, some luck. Beyond the castle walls, towards Stonehear, there is a forest, Neverturn. My parents are buried upon a bluff, nestled amongst the trees. Theirs was the only love I ever knew. I was torn from them in life, but perhaps I can return to them in death. Take my ring. See that it rests beside their bones.
May you find peace at last. Don't tell me. The only way to the capital
is through that gate, just as you surmise.
There's an army down there, Joshua.
Yes, but I don't see any dominance.
Kill!
Joshua, this one's bigger than the others.
And Nina, by the look of it.
We can rest here if you like.
Don't worry, I'll be fine. Look, Clive.
By the Founder, the place is a fortress. Villages. No knights. Not even any bodies. One could almost believe the whole kingdom had turned to Kashyyyk. last of its kind.
Fly, Ambrosia.
Be able to see all the way to stone here. As fine a resting place as any man could hope for. Reunited with those he loves at last. Come on. Does it bother you that we haven't heard a single human sound?
Everything about this place bothers me.
Be safe.
Soil and stone!
The calm before the storm.
There's only one way into that city. Across the bridge. through the main gate. Right into the midst of whatever is left of the late King's army. Are you ready for this?
As ready as I'll ever be. Stroke of good fortune, perhaps?
I hope you're right.
So do I.
Waiting for.
Attack!
Here's your award. Joshua!
Trust me, I'm your shield, remember?
Quickly, before we're cut off for good.
If it is like the others, the entrance to the inner sanctum will be at the foot of the crystal. We're almost there. Once we step onto that bridge, we'll be easy targets.
Then we better move quickly.
castle, then.
I don't see any other way.
Thank you. strength for the Mother Crystal.
Farewell.
No end to them. The whole bloody army's here.
Stand back, Joshua. I'm summoning Ifrit.
Stop, Clive. You mustn't. We still have a long way to go. If you tap your strength here, you'll have none left to destroy the heart.
Then you'd rather die?
Surprised to see us.
How did you?
Gav. He told us exactly where you'd be. Even sniffed out a crack in the castle wall. And when we saw the heavens come crashing down, we had no choice but to believe him. It's been quite a day.
To what do we owe this honor?
A debt I would see repaid.
Prince Dion. It's good to see you well.
So, this must be Ifrit. Your uncle bade me give you a message. Listen to your heart. It will guide your steel true. Your father would expect no less. That is all.
Thank you.
For everything, Your Highness.
Dion, please.
You do realize the only thing we've freed so far is this wall from its foundations, right? Now, if your lord and ladyship's quite finished...
Well said, Gaff. We have work to do.
I suppose is how I can say to make you change your mind. So I'll just tell you to stay safe. Nan won't take kindly to losing her best customer, especially after letting us carry all this stuff all the way to Ash.
And we wouldn't want to anger old Nan.
You mean, you'll buy summer offers? I've got some good stuff for you. How else you need? All done then. Good luck, Clive.
Each parting brings the hope of reunion. I missed you, Clive.
I missed you too. I couldn't have made it this far without you, Torgol.
If Sid were here today, I reckon he'd be proud of you, Clive.
He'd be proud of us all.
You see, Clive, we're not alone. If we are to win the day, we must all play our part. And ours. Ours lies beyond those doors.
We've fought long and hard for this moment. Sid's dream, our dream, is within our grasp.
We need only endure this final trial, and we shall. Together.
You all know what it is that awaits us beyond this gate. And we shall face it together.
Aye.
Seems our host would rather we remain. I will stay them.
We will stay them. Go!
Just don't keep us waiting.
Thank you.
Joshua! Joshua! Wake up!
Clive, is that you? This isn't stone here.
Welcome to our darkness. A rift between worlds wherein your kind might reflect.
Show yourself!
Grave and many are the sins of man. And we would have you know them. All of them. As fate has seen fit to deliver you home, consider this our welcoming gift.
It would seem we are trapped.
And the only way out is through Ultima. We find him and we leave.
If you are to comprehend the full extent of your transgressions, we must go back to the beginning. When the world was still young, we visited upon it a miracle, magic, and in its light did all life flourish. For this boon would prove heavy. A pall descended upon the land, painting the horizon black as night. Though we labored to forestall its spread, in this one endeavor we stood powerless. And so we fled, that we might endure, that we might discover a means of salvation.
But if it was magic that caused the blight, what of the mother crystals?
I expect he'll tell us soon enough.
Salvation, alas, was not readily to be had. First, we would require a land unvisited by the stain of corruption. An unprecedented journey lay before us, one beyond the limits of our fleshly bodies. And so we cast them off. Thus, stripped to our very spirit, did we find our new paradise. A land as pure as driven snow. Valisthea. There would the true work begin. For the black crept yet behind us. and soon did we arrive at a solution. The illness having spread to every organ, there was but one escape from this fate: to start afresh.
With a new world. The one for which Barnabas labored. A paradise free from the blight where his god awaits. And where, if we only forfeit our wills and abandon everything we hold dear, humanity can join him. So, Ultima would have us follow in the footsteps of the king.
And follow we shall. For now. Surely he cannot be so blind to his own hypocrisy.
Not blind, just unwilling to admit the truth. Though we are one and the same.
Ifrit, or what's left of him.
Long have our ashes lain cold for want of a spark. Cast your eyes upon them and see what you must become. Valisthea cannot endure a second claim upon her being. The avarice of man drives her ever closer to destruction. But she may yet be saved by you. It is what you were born to do. Why we nursed you and fed you, as your own mother should have. And now that you are fully grown, our Muthos, it is time at last for you to serve your purpose.
To right your wrongs. If our sin is wanting to survive, then you are as marked by it as we are. The fault is yours. Our wills were born because you abandoned us. And now, you would have us forfeit them. All for a place in your new paradise.
Do you imagine yourselves worthy of one? Mankind has no place in our world. Is this truly so difficult to comprehend? We only ever require you, Muthos, when the time comes to bid this wretched realm farewell. None shall follow, none shall remain.
What do you mean, none?
This is our world. Once the land's rebirth is complete, humanity will have served its purpose. Why would we continue to suffer that which has caused us so much vexation?
Because the land doesn't belong to you. It belongs to us all! What?
That is where you are mistaken. You own nothing but your precious will.
Brother.
I can't do this alone.
And you don't have to.
I grow weary of your descent. Now you must learn that this master will not tolerate disobedience.
My friends, my family, we have all suffered, all fought to survive. This world may be flawed. It may be broken. But it's all we have. And if we can't share it, I see only one other choice. You have to go.
You may have created us, Ultima. It's time we lived on our own terms. This isn't your world anymore. It's ours.
Bow down, offenders, hearts disdained. Thank you. such foul intent may not be sublimed through gainstanding. Only with heads hung low is penance paid. O wretched mortals, incapable even of contrition, in fitting season shall we reap our harvest. This chance, and still you would raise your hand against the Lord.
What now?
The darkness bends. He means to end us.
It wouldn't be the first time. Let's make it his last.
Your fate is inexorable. Surrender the vessel unto the darkness. Surrender it unto us. Have made you strong, yet your soul remains heavy with sin. Absolution is nigh. Repent, and all shall be forgiven.
Tell me, Clive, how many lives have you saved since taking my name?
Fewer than we have ruined. Wherever we go, we leave a sea of tears in our wake.
These are the wages of your will, son.
What good are our choices when all they ever bring, all they will ever bring, is death?
There's no atoning, Clive. No matter how hard you try.
So why not leave it all behind?
Leave it all behind.
Somebody save me. Won't anybody love me?
I yearn, yet still she is not mine. Have I not given enough?
From will is born desire, and it is this which consumes you, rendering you incomplete.
Do you not see how the world bends and warps under the weight of your hungering hearts? What if it could all just go away?
Just go away. This is real. Wake up. It's time to go home, Clive. Clive.
That's right. You're my brother.
Brother?
Once more, lest you forget.
Huh.
My name is Clive. Clive Rosfield. Look, Ultima.
Even here, the light of the vessel's will cannot be quenched. And the Phoenix, his trespass should not have been possible. Not possible unless... unless he has been with Muthos all along. The mark of the Phoenix, emblazoned upon his heart, made manifest by the power of will alone. The power of creation. Can it be? Are their wills truly so potent?
Are you still talking?
Sorry to wake you, but I think it may be time to leave. This place...
And once again, does my creation stray from the path laid before it? Steeped in conceit, you fancy yourself a god. You embrace Logos. But we will put an end to this hubris.
What are you talking about?
In the halls of origin, does our true power quicken? And there shall you be made complete. Soon, Muthos, soon you will discover how little you know of suffering. So the crystals are no more. Yet in their silence, a new song rings. Its chorus building. A crescendo as it enters its final movement. stirring those long aslumber to waking.